Could you imagine your life without any fear? Could you imagine what you could achieve without suffering from this background noise and this background voice of fear? Well, today I'm here to talk to you about fear extinction hacks and specifically what supplements can be used to combat fear. For those of you who are brand new to my channel, my mission is to bring you the most cutting-edge health information that you'll struggle to find on Google. So please do me a favor, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment down below if you have any questions relating to this video. So ultimately, today I'm here to look at specific fear extinction hacks and specific pathway or a range of pathways that can actually help to eliminate fear. So first of all, let's take a look at how we define fear. Funnily enough, I've actually always looked at fear as standing for false evidence appearing real. But if we actually have a look at the true criteria and definition for fear, it goes by the following. The brain circuits that create our sense of fear rely on ancient hardwired components of the limbic system, but also use sensory processing to determine what we can become afraid of. So fear is actually an emotional state of anxiety that occurs in response to a perceived threat, and that can trigger a variety of defensive reactions within the body. So because fear is or can be attached to stimuli of various kinds, it can serve as either an adaptive or maladaptive role in the human condition. For example, it can promote the avoidance and escape from genuinely threatening situations, or when attached to innocuous stimuli, it can actually promote unnecessary stress and an irresponsible or irrational stress-based response. We can see here the pathways of fear within the brain and body and some of its downstream effects. So we can see that the prefrontal cortex, which regulates the stress response by making things seem less scary, will interpret or perceive a certain type of stressor and then re-encode that into specific loops within the brain to make the human or person no longer perceive that threat again as stressful. So we can see that the amygdala also detects things in the environment. It scans things within our environment to see if they're dangerous or if they're a threat. And then it also then sends a signal to the hypothalamus, which sort of regulates and is the master regulator of all hormones or most hormones in the body. It wakes up this pituitary gland, which then sends signals to the adrenal glands, which are located just above the kidneys, to release cortisol and even perhaps noradrenaline as well. Here we can see the fear loop pathways. So again, the prefrontal cortex and the prelimbic and infralimbic systems. We can see that the neurotransmitter glutamate mediates the response from the prefrontal cortex down to the basolateral amygdala. We can then also see how the hippocampus is responsible for cue and contextual information that can also link in with the prefrontal cortex as well. And then we know that the central nucleus of the amygdala also plays a role in mediating the stress response and perceiving threats. And we can also see that GABA also plays a role in blocking that response there. And then fear expression yet again is also mediated through glutamate, which is the primary excitatory neurotransmitter in the brain. So you don't have to understand much there, just understand, I guess, the major regions within the brain. So we got the prefrontal cortex, the hippocampus, we said the hypothalamus before, and the amygdala. So we can see these key regions within the brain mediate and govern the fear-based response. Here's the very first fear extinction pathway that we want to be tackling or addressing. It's known as HDAC inhibition. So HDAC stands for histone deacetylase. Now, this particular enzyme basically mediates how genes are turned on and off. So when we inhibit this enzyme, it actually keeps genes from being turned off after they've been turned on. So they can actually act as a switch to regulate and mediate the fear extinction process. It's now known that inhibiting HDAC can play a critical role in fear extinction, memory enhancement, social verbal navigation, addictive behaviors, extinction, and even more. So we can see that this histone D-acetylase, there are many types within the body. The one that we're focused on is the histone D-acetylase within the brain, and we basically want to inhibit this enzyme. And there is some pretty impressive research that points towards inhibition of this enzyme to improve fear extinction. The first fear extinction compound that I want to explore is one that you've probably heard me talk about before. It's called sodium butyrate. Now, sodium butyrate is actually a short chain fatty acid that's produced within the microbiome. Yet again, a link between the gut and the brain. We can see that butyrate is actually produced from a high fiber diet. A lot of, you know, fiber rich diets actually help to produce this short chain fatty acid, but we can also use sodium butyrate in supplemental form, which has a variety of health benefits that's probably too long to list on just this one video. And again, if you want to know where to purchase sodium butyrate, it will be linked down below. There are some pretty impressive psychological benefits to sodium butyrate. Specifically, we can see how butyrate affects mitochondrial activity. It affects G protein coupled receptors. It specifically affects that histone acetylation, which is what I mentioned before. That blue box there, the histone acetylation, that is why we're interested in sodium butyrate, because it targets that specific pathway within the brain. And then again, it plays a role in microbiome homeostasis. So going back to the mitochondrial activity, sodium butyrate has been studied in Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, Huntington's, stroke, mitochondrial encephalopathy, and adrenoleukodystrophy, which is some sort of adrenal disorder. G-coupled protein receptors, it plays a role in metabolic disorders, insulin resistance in the brain, Parkinson's disease yet again. So we can see there how sodium butyrate has some broad spectrum effects that can help to combat fear. So here's the first study. Sodium butyrate inhibits a broad range of histone D-acetylases in the brain. The title of the study was Measuring Histone D-acetylase Inhibition in the Brain. It's awesome to see that they're looking at specifically targeting this pathway. Although this is not the only pathway involved in banishing fear and reducing fear, it does seem to be a crucial component of reducing the fear response. Not only does this pathway need to be addressed, but of course, many neurotransmitters need to also be addressed as well. Specifically, dopamine, GABA, histamine, orexin, oxytocin, even some other neuromodulators as well. But we can see that sodium butyrate can perhaps form part of our anti-fear stack as well. Again, this study here looks at sodium butyrate. The title of the study was Sodium Butyrate Enhances Fear Extinction and Rescues Hippocampal Acetylcholinesterase Activity in a Rat Model of Post-Traumatic Stress Disorder. Acetylcholinesterase is the enzyme that degrades acetylcholine, so it breaks down acetylcholine. So it actually, sodium butyrate rescues dysfunctional hippocampal acetylcholinesterase, which is crucial for preserving memory and improving cognitive function. So they do believe that impaired histone, obviously the histone acetylase, but then also the acetylcholinesterase also plays a role in the development of a fear-based response and the ability to banish fear. The next compound that can help to eliminate fear based off initial clinical trials. Unfortunately, this compound is very difficult to source. If somebody has found a vendor or a recommended vendor, let me know. I'd be curious to contact the company and learn more about their ingredient. But D-cycloserine is the second compound. D-cycloserine is, you know, it's being heavily researched in the context of schizophrenia and also the fear-based response. And you can see that the title of this study was Facilitation of Fear Extinction by D-cycloserine, Theoretical and Clinical Implications. So have a look at how D-cycloserine works. They believe that, you know, D-cycloserine or DCS, is a partial NMDA agonist, which seems to facilitate the extinction of learned fear, which is very exciting to see research on. And we can see that this study here was titled Neurocognitive Processes in Decycloserine-Augmented Single-Session Exposure Therapy for Anxiety, a randomized placebo-controlled trial. And I'll read out what they noted. So drugs targeting the N-methyl D-aspartate, so the NMDA receptors, and the ability to learn new associations have been proposed as adjunct treatments to boost the success of exposure therapy for anxiety disorders. So in this study, panic disorder patients were randomized to single dose D-cycloserine at 250 milligrams or matching placebo 2 hours before one session of exposure therapy. And one day after treatment, threat bias for fearful faces and amygdala threat response was lower in the D-cycloserine group compared to placebo. In addition, there was a lower magnitude which predicted greater clinical improvement during follow-up across groups. And while this experimental study is of a preliminary nature due to its limited sample size, these findings highlight a neurocognitive potential mechanism by which D-cycloserine may exert its augmentative effects on psychological treatment and bring forward a marker that may help understand and facilitate the development of combination treatments for anxiety. Really promising to see research on D-cycloserine to combat anxiety and also fear extinction. If you guys have any other, you know, suggestions or strategies to banish fear, I'd love to hear from you down below. Drop a comment below. What has worked for you to help combat fear? I'd love to hear your experiences. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you learned something new. Please be sure to follow me on Instagram at ergogenic_health. Check out all of my other amazing videos on this channel. I do spend a lot of time recording these videos to help benefit, you know, millions of people. So thanks everyone for tuning in. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.